So welcome all once again. So far as we have discussed about the inversions of kinematic chains. So we have three different types of kinematic chain: four bar chain, then single slider crank chain, and double slider crank chain. So far as we have discussed about the inversions of four bar chain and single slider crank chain. Now in this video, we will see what are the inversions of double slider crank chain. So as the name indicates, it is double slider. That means there will be two sliders. Out of the four links, two will be sliders. That is the specialty of double slider crank chain. So now we will see some of the important inversions of this double slider crank chain. So first one is elliptical trammel, then second one is Kochiok mechanism, and then third one is old arms coupling. So we will see how these things work and what is the use of those mechanisms. So first one is this elliptical trammel. This is the first inversion of double slider crank chain. So here you can see there are two sliders. This is the first slider, this is the second slider, and these two sliders are connected with the help of this particular connecting rod. So this slider will constitute one link, this slider will constitute the second link, and this black colored connecting rod which connects these two sliders constitute the third link. So these are the three movable links: one connecting rod and two sliders, and this is sliding along a path which is fixed. So this symbol, or this plus symbol, indicates the path upon which the slider is sliding. So that is, you can see it traces an elliptical path. So this is the path traced by this particular mechanism. So it is traced an elliptical path. That is why it is called a elliptical trammel. So this is the animation of elliptical trammel. So this is the diagram you have to draw for examination. So two dimensional detailed diagram of elliptical trammel. Here you can see we have the link number 1, which is this particular slider. Then we have the link number 2, which is the bar or the connecting rod. Then we have the link number 3, which is the second slider. And we have this slotted plate. This entire bag plate is called the slotted plate, which is the fixed link, or here this name is link number 4. So along this slotted plate, the slider will move, and a particular point on the slider will trace a elliptical path. You can see the point here, the point P. The point P will always trace an elliptical path like this. So that means it is tracing an elliptical path. That's why it is called elliptical trammel. So at any instant we can see the location of the particular point P. It is given by C of XY. So here also it traces an elliptical path. So that is the purpose of elliptical trammel. So that is the first important inversion under double slider crank chain. So next we have the second one, that is Kochiok mechanism. So here also you can see the purpose of this Kochiok mechanism is to convert the rotary motion of the crank to reciprocating or oscillating motion. That is the purpose of Kochiok mechanism. Here you can see the blue colored element. This is blue and this is also blue. Those act as a fixer link, or those are the fixer links. Then we have two sliders here. One is this red colored element, and the red colored element is one slider, and we can see another sliding element which slides along the red colored element. This is that particular slider constitutes the second slider, and we have a connecting rod that connects between the slider and the fixer link, that is colored as green gear. So the purpose is to convert the rotary motion to reciprocating motion. Here also we have two sliders, red colored slider, and we have another blue colored slider. So that is Kochiok mechanism. Now this is the two dimensional diagram of this Kochiok mechanism you have to draw for your examinations. So again you can see here we have the frame. So the entire frame is named as link number 1 here. So that is a fixer link. Then we have the crank. This one is the crank, which is generating a circular path. That is the second link. Then the third link is a slider, first slider. This slider is the third link, and we have the fourth link, the second slider. This is the second slider. You can see the second slider here. That second slider is the fourth link. So we have four links, out of which link number one is fixer, and there are two sliders. That is link number three and link number four constitute the slider. So that means it is a double slider crank mechanism, or inversion of double slider crank chain. The purpose is to convert the rotary motion to reciprocating motion, or vice versa. That is Schwarzkopf mechanism. Next one is we have the Oldham's coupling. So the purpose of Oldham's coupling is to connect two shafts whose axes are not parallel, or there is a slight misalignment between the axes of the two shafts. We can use this Oldham's coupling to connect those two shafts. So here you can see two shafts. This is the first shaft, and this blue colored element is the second shaft, and the green colored element in the middle is the Oldham's coupling, which is used to connect between the two shafts. So that is the purpose of Oldham's coupling. So now let us see the diagram of the Oldham's coupling in detail. So this is the diagram of Oldham's coupling. You can draw this for your examinations. So here you can see we have again a supporting frame. This is a supporting frame upon which the driven shaft and driving shaft is attached. So that is the link number 2. Here this name is link number 2, the supporting frame, or that is fixed link, which is the link number 2 here in this diagram. Then we have the driving shaft. It is a driving shaft, and driving shaft flange. This is the flange of the driving shaft. So flange of the driving shaft is named as link number 1. Then we have the driven shaft here, and the flange of the driven shaft, that is, this is the flange of the driven shaft, that is named as link number 3. Now that is the driving and driven shaft. Then we have the centerpiece or Oldham's coupling. This is the Oldham's coupling or link number 4, that is the center one. So that is the Oldham's coupling. So we have the link number 2 as the fixer link, link number 1 as the driving shaft flange, and link number 3 as the driven shaft flange, and link number 4 as the Oldham's coupling. So there are 4 links, and it is constitute the Oldham's coupling. The purpose is to connect between two shafts whose axes are not parallel. So this is the another diagram of Oldham's coupling. You can see two slots here. This is one, T1 and T2. The T1 and T2 slot will fit into the slots of the shaft. These are the slots of the shaft, you can see. And these two projections, that is T1 and T2, will fit into the slots of the driving and driven shaft on either side. So that is used to transmit the power from driving shaft to driven shaft. That is the purpose of this Oldham's coupling. So this is the third or another important inversion of double slider crank chain. So these are some of the important inversions of double slider crank chain. So far as we have discussed about the kinematic chains like 4-bar chain, single slider crank chain, double slider crank chain, how are they made up of, and then how we can make different mechanisms. Then we have studied what are inversions, and how inversions of different kinematic chains can be made. And then we have discussed about some of the inversions of these different types of kinematic chains. So these are the things about the kinematic chain, the mechanism, the inversion of mechanism. So if you like the videos, do subscribe to the channel. So I will be uploading new videos in the next classes. So stay tuned. Thank you.